a productive and inspiring day, and thanks for choosing Interlachen.
Can you turn on this black and white show? Maybe show me younger folks, not who the Three Stooges are. These are just knuckleheads, buffoons who just beat each other up all the time, and it was Jackass before Jackass, and it was just great TV. And I remember my dad came home one day and was like, guess what I'm doing tomorrow? And guess who's coming along? What? He's like, I'm gonna bring Bubble from the Three Stooges. He's the last living member of the Three Stooges. And we're going to his home in Bel Air, a mansion, we're interviewing him poolside. And my brother and I are like, we freaked out and we got, I think it was like Canada at the time or something like that. So this was like a huge deal. And so I got to tag along and see my dad interview Mo. We got to meet Mo. He was frail and brave, and it was just all power. I mean, it's just how we got blown away by that. So we got to, and then we got to be part of the story. Part of this angle of the story was, hey, the influence of the Three Stooges on the younger generation is still watching. So my brother and I got to do some impersonations of the Three Stooges that they actually used in the story. So that was my very first time on television. I remember seeing myself on the nightly news that night on NBC, and I was just like, okay, that's kind of cool. Like, you know, this is something about that, especially at that age, that was something that also was formed in me. And then so, you know, here it is, the journalism side, the comedic side, and just being surrounded. I've learned about RFKs, I've learned about RMCs, I've learned about them maximizers and woos, and so thank you. This has been enlightening. Have yourself a great day, and enjoy the night.